So the scripture for today is from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 17, verse 20, and it reads, "For truly I tell you, if you have faith the size of a mustard seed, and you will say to this mountain, 'Move from here to there,' it will move, and nothing will be impossible for you." And this is Jesus speaking, of course. And the meditation is the following. Elijah was a human being just like us, says St. James in his epistle, chapter 5, verse 17. But the feelings which disquieted Elijah took the proper direction, concentrating all their strength on intense and ardent prayer, when he prostrated himself 7 times before the Lord on Mount Carmel. And the heavens gave rain, and the earth brought forth her fruit, as St. James says in chapter 5, verse 18 of his epistle. This ardent, relentless prayer, this insistence in supplication, is an example for each of us. No one has the right to say that he does not know how to pray. Elijah was a human being like us, and his courage, his faith, and his firm, unshakable trust can be ours as well. The weakest and frailest of us, the most insignificant, can be inflamed with an unshakable faith, and having received in his heart this great gift, can move mountains and can achieve the unachievable. Let us also, in complete humility, pray with that force with which the kingdom of heaven is taken, for it is taken by those who use force, as it says in the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 11, verse 12. Let us be insistent in prayer until a cloud comes over us and a rain of grace abundantly pours over our parched earth. And a poor human heart, an individual community of people, and a whole unfortunate country can be like dry, barren soil, which seems to have hopelessly perished. But the heavens gave rain, and the earth brought forth her fruit. When and why? When a human being like us completely gave himself to the Lord, when he burned with love and faith for God, and when he relentlessly demanded the fulfillment of his prayer. Oh, let us not forget this. Let us learn to pray like Elijah, and in reply to our more ardent prayer, the driest heart in the most barren soil, irrigated from above by a stream of grace, will be reborn to a new life and will bear fruit 100-fold. So that's the end of the meditation. And of course, St. James says that Elijah was a human being like us, but I think that the chances of our achieving the same results as Elijah achieved are probably not very great. But of course, we should do what we can, and I'm sure that God will hear whatever we can pray for and the extent to which we can pray, and he will certainly respond one way or the other.